Good evening, boys and ghouls, and here we are once again for another blood-curdling entry to what I call Crypt Discussions. I am your favorite hair-raising, goosebump-inducing fear leader of the macabre anthology, Jonathan, and tonight I have a real treat in store for you all, Tales the Game Part 3. Man, oh man, does the information keep on coming, and this video is going to be a long one, folks. Guys, if you have been following CryptTube since it was dug up, you more than likely have already seen my coverage of Tales the Game that was meant to be released back in 1997 for the PC. This was a serious subject that I wanted to tackle, especially since no one has ever done research on it, or was even remotely interested in figuring out what had happened with the game's cancellation and release. Back in the early 2000s, there were only just two pictures of the 3D model Crypt Keeper created by Jim Lutka that were hidden in the deep black hole of the internet where search engine results weren't as broad as they are now. Fast forward 18 years and two coverage videos later, we now have new information and content. When I first made these videos, I had no idea how fruitful my research would have been because of them. I didn't think for a single second that they would have had the amount of success that they have had recently. However, once they were uploaded, I found my videos being circulated and shared through several different websites and networks. Bloody Disgusting, Reddit, The Retroist, Sci-Fi Wire, Den of Geek, Horror Fuel, amongst many others, saw interest in my story. I am even finding my videos as first page results when searched on Google. So not to toot my own horn, I do say humbly that I am absolutely thrilled that this game is getting the recognition that it deserves, more so for the fans to see and enjoy. The way I see it, me being a huge fan of the television series and the EC franchise as a whole, I know that if the roles were reversed, I would be having a geek out leveled heart attack. But I digress. Now the reason I bring that up is due to the fact that it is because of this coverage that a certain individual has discovered these articles and stories about the game and has stepped out of the shadows and into the light to give us even more than what we have now. That man is Joseph Cotton. Now before I get into this deep story, I want to say first and foremost that I have not discussed fully with Joe what would be discussed in this video, so I will save heavy details for the Graphic Zone merger and bankruptcy for another video that I hope to actually have him in so you the fans can hear straight from him. Joseph Cotton, after discovering the story written by Vic Sage from The Retroist, soon ended up requesting to join the Beloved Tales Facebook fan page and even followed my Twitter. When Vic Sage first wrote the article, I shared it with the group a while back, and it wasn't until Joe was added to the group that he decided to drop some knowledge on the members and reveal that he was in fact the character animator for Inkscape. Inkscape had hired him to animate the graphics and characters, including limp synchronization. What amazing luck to have this man join our group and provide us this information. But of course, Joe was not done. He proceeded to drop an image of one of the opening sequences for the Tales meant to be in the game, Big Top Terror. This image showcases the old witch breaking through a banner in Porky Pig Merry Melodies fashion, seemingly pulling us in to start the story.
Hurry, hurry, hurry! The show's about to begin, and it costs one-tenth of a dollar. One thin crime! It's a classic romantic triangle. A boy, a girl, an elephant. I call it Big Top Terror.
Then, he soon follows this teaser image with another fun fact, stating that the character of Killjoy was in fact modeled directly after Joe himself. After doing a side-by-side comparison, I can definitely see a huge physical and facial resemblance. As all of you can easily expect, I was ecstatic. Not only was this man confirming the information in the previous videos, but he was providing the group members and myself even more, even going as far as to tell us that he has much more readily available to produce to us at our request. Needless to say, I didn't hesitate on that opportunity. I immediately sought out Joe and messaged him directly to try to get as much information as I could about his involvement, the development of the game, and the situation regarding the cancellation and buyout of Inkscape. Joe laid it all out on the table for me. Being once involved with the Voyager Education media source, he was eventually brought in by Inkscape to handle the game's lip-syncing as well as character animation since Lutka left the project. Based on previous information, this was due to health issues. Joe was more than up for the task, especially since already having experience in the lip-syncing process by doing work on a movie some of you might already be familiar with called Baby Geniuses. But his other film credits not only go to the Baby Geniuses franchise, but also his work with Sky Captain and The World of Tomorrow. Not only that, but he told me that the game was primarily being handled with a program known as Electric Image Animation System. Electric Image was the primary program that had created the visual effects for many of the films that we all know and love right now, such as Star Wars, Terminator, Men in Black, and Pirates of the Caribbean, just to name a few. Using this program, he was even able to create character models, objects, and provide environmental texture mapping to the cutscenes, shown for example in this introduction clip used for High Tide Terror from Crime Suspense Stories No. 1. It goes without saying that he wasn't alone in creating all of this, as he had a team consisting of Brian Spite, Alex Arco, David Hutchins, who all provided additional assistance in art, conception, models, and backgrounds, as well as David Javelosa, who was the sound design director. I just want to go on record and say that as much as I enjoy finding new information on this, it never gets easier knowing that the company responsible for this lost gem got such a sad ending. Even after doing further research, I learned that Graphic Zone was created by a Charles R. Courtwright and his wife Angela Aber. Unfortunately, I have not been able to find any contact information on either one of them to try to get their position on the acquisition and bankruptcy declaration, but maybe somehow this video could lead us to that day too. On the flip side, Joe was nice enough to even share new video clips and teaser images with me, even going as far as to drop the official premise of the game and the two official endings. Quote unquote, "The story, as I recall, is Killjoy is trying to make a deadline on Halloween night. The material he's working on is sickeningly saccharine duckies and such. He wigs out when they morph into the old witch and vault keeper though, whereupon he's sucked into the drawing board into the crypt keeper's lair, where he has to solve some puzzles to survive. Now please remember, I may not have this correct, it's been a few years, I'm such a pack rat, I may have some of the scripts and timing sheets I used. I know that Killjoy was stuck in the vault and he trundled around looking for the keys, solving various puzzles or some such."
"Greetings, Killjoy. Love that name. I'm the Crypt Keeper. Heard of me? Of course you have. I'm a multimedia megastar. How's your career going? No, don't tell me. Some things are too scary even for me. Want to know what your problem is? You lack inspiration. You're sitting around drawing duckies when you should be a regular Vincent Van Gogh. Horror comics, Killjoy. That's where you belong. How do I know? I can see inside that twisted little mind of yours. I see your id, kid. Tell you what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna give you a shot. Draw me a great Crypt story, and you're hired. What do you mean you wouldn't know how to begin? Look around my lair, Killboy. It's full of great stories. I'm offering you the keys to success. Now get busy or get lost. Find those keys. It doesn't take a Sherlock Bones."
This is starting to easily remind me of how I was piecing together the whole story just based on the images that were provided to me by Mike Vosburgh in part 1. But Cotton goes in again to reveal the endings. Quote, "The axe in Killjoy's head ending is when he makes a Faustian bargain with the Crypt Keeper. He becomes stuck in his own cartoon." End quote. And he wasn't shy about dropping the alternate ending though either. Quote, "The other ending, Killjoy leaves Crypt Keeper behind, whereupon the Vault Keeper and Old Witch axe the Crypt Keeper." End quote. It is absolutely nuts to see these clips and videos nearly confirming my initial hunch about the plot and premise. Of course, this is only the tip of the iceberg, my friends, and based on the conversation Joe and I have had about the game, there's still yet more to come. I also went and sent these videos to the Crypt Keeper himself, Mr. John Kassir, and he was absolutely amazed by them, but just like any of us, he was also wondering if there would be a possible release of the full game. And from what I assume, the game is currently, and if you'll forgive the expression, in pieces, and hasn't been fully assembled. Most of the game is in parts, and even if it were put together successfully after all these years, there is no guarantee that one could actually map out controls and play it. Of course, this is all my own assumption, but Joe has informed me that he and a friend of his that also worked sound design on the game, David Javelosa, talked about possibly putting what they have together and possibly create a video demo of the game's cinematics. What I would like to one day see myself is actual gameplay. So far, based on what I have researched and what I am seeing, everything has been pretty accurate to my findings, and if the original interview transcript that I found about the game being an interactive comic book where Killjoy explores the crypt and solves puzzles says anything, then we could have had a very, very unique game on our hands. Well, that's all for now, kiddies. I don't know about you, but I certainly lost my head over these new clips and images. Did you like or hate them? Let me know what your rotting minds have contemplated deep in the catacombs of the comments section. Also, don't forget to subscribe to Joseph Cotton's YouTube channel provided in the description box down below. That way you can get first viewings of any additional Crypt Game content and show him some love and thanks. If you like this video, mash the like button to pieces, subscribe, and hit the notification button to get your latest Dead Time stories here only on CryptTube. Have a good fright and pleasant screams.
Sorry, I was just buzzing with anticipation after this decapitation. Flies in the blooder milk, shoo fly shoo.